Opponents of a Nashville mayoral candidate are going on the offensive by insinuating that she's a secret atheist. Kind of an interesting attack here. Now, they say that they've witnessed her omit the phrase "under God" from the Pledge of Allegiance. Oh my goodness. Oh no. And this is according to the Tennessean. Now, Megan Berry, who is currently a member of the Metro Council overseeing Nashville and Davidson County, is being accused of quietly refusing to say the words "under God" during the Pledge of Allegiance, which she denies in audio recordings from the Tennessean Contradict. Now, who's bringing this up? And why is this an issue? Well, this comes from Barry's rival, David Fox, who's running some ads accusing her of being a secret atheist. Not a secret Muslim, a secret atheist. Wow. Now, let's see. Council member Duane Dominy says, "It's important that you know what I've witnessed before you vote. Right after being sworn in, it was pointed out to me that during the Pledge of Allegiance, Megan Berry skips the words, under God." There's another Fox supporter, Councilman Michael Craddock, corroborates Dominy's claim, saying, "I never in 4 years heard her say the words, under God, when we would recite the pledge." Here's the funny thing about this. The Pledge of Allegiance, if you didn't know, was written by a socialist named Francis Bellamy. And in its original version, it did not contain the words "under God." That was added around 1950, in the midst of the Red Scare. Now, if she did, in fact, skip the words "under God," she would actually be saying the pledge the way that it was supposed to be said. The way that it was originally intended to be. Fascinating. Now, Fox denied that his campaign had anything to do with this ad, but it's not the first time Barry's been accused of being a secret atheist. So here's what's funny about this, right? You realize there is no litmus test based on religion to get into office, right? At least there shouldn't be, according to the Constitution. There shouldn't be any litmus test for office based on religion. We are a secular nation. A lot of people seem to forget that these days. Now, last week, Fox began running ads targeting Nashville's African-American population, which accused her of being too secular to run the city and bashed her Vanderbilt professor husband, Bruce Berry, for criticizing the Jesus Industrial Complex, which, by the way, I'm going to start using that because that's kind of awesome. The Jesus Industrial Complex. They're, quote, "They're opposing the National Day of Prayer, opposing prayer before high school football games, fighting with Christian faith-based organizations that he called," and I quote, "part of the Jesus Industrial Complex." Can you believe that? According to one of these ads. Well, yeah, of course I can believe that. You know why? Because most of the time, faith-based organizations are usually breaking the First Amendment while also being tax-exempt. A recent example is, and this wasn't a faith-based organization, but an example of people breaking the Constitution, was this coach leading a mass baptism on school grounds. I remember doing that story the other day. Now, that's clearly a government employee endorsing one specific religion over the others. I'm just saying. Now, the sad thing, and there is a downside to this story, these attacks actually may end up being successful. Why? Well, because Americans distrust atheists. You guys remember that 2011 study that showed that people trust rapists about the same as atheists. Ooh, disaster. So yeah, that attack may be pretty successful. And in that, I leave you on a downer. It is sad that free thinkers and atheists are viewed still in 2015 with so much distrust and so much hostility in America, arguably one of the first secular nations in the world. What the fuck happened?